Did you know that when you smoke in your car with children, you're exposing them to some 4,000 different chemicals, 50 at least of which are known to cause cancer, and that comes from your secondhand smoke even with the windows open. So in a bid to protect the 3 million or so children who are exposed to secondhand smoke in cars, from today, the 1st of October 2015, it's illegal to smoke in cars with anybody under the age of 18 travelling with you. I've come here to Newcastle University to look at the results of a brand new experiment which demonstrates really clearly the damage done by secondhand smoke to those children who travel with you. Right, Jasmine, show me the kind of monitors that you've used for this experiment. Where have you located them?
Okay, so most of the monitors are in the back of the car here around the passenger.
Yeah.
And we have a dummy child to replicate this. And we also have one monitor that's hooked up near to the driver so we can compare the levels around the mouth of the driver to the levels around the mouth of the child. So we tried to replicate the realistic scenarios, and we've also monitored both with the windows open and the windows closed so we can compare.
Dr. Anil Namdeo led the research and is able to show the levels of exposure to fine particulate matter from secondhand smoke in each of the scenarios in the data suite at Newcastle University.
What we have found that the recommended level is, say, 25 microgram per meter cube. Peak levels are more than 100 to 200 times higher than the recommended levels. So when young children are exposed to these dangerously high levels of chemicals which are known to cause cancer, then their health will be significantly affected.
Dr. Malcolm Brody is a paediatrician and an expert in respiratory health. He worked closely with the research team, and his major concern is the effect these invisible chemicals have on the developing bodies of children.
So secondhand smoke is damaging to everyone, but children are particularly vulnerable to it. So they breathe more quickly, so they actually take more of these particles in. And we know that their airways are smaller and their lungs are still developing. So this makes them especially sensitive to the effects of secondhand smoke.
Louise Morris quit smoking 7 years ago. One of her main motivations to stop was to protect her young daughter, Leah.
I smoked while she was in the car from quite a young age, actually, from a few months old, which... Looking back now, I think, oh, how stupid was I? Had the window down, smoke going out the window, thought, it's great, it's fine. She's not near the cigarette. She's in the back. She's nowhere near any smoke I'm blowing out. But you can see the smoke going out the window. It's the bit that you can't see. It's the invisible danger that you can't see, the chemicals that are building up in the car that she's breathing in.
Dr. Gina Radford is Deputy Chief Medical Officer of England.
The law that will come into effect on the 1st of October basically will penalise anyone who is caught in a car smoking when there are children who are under 18 present. What this legislation means that the driver and the smoker will be fined £50 should they be found smoking when any child under the age of 18 is present in the car.
The shocking results of the experiment are set to coincide with new laws banning smoking in vehicles with under 18s present, and it also marks the start of Stoptober, Britain's biggest mass quit event. Now, if you can stop smoking for just 28 days, you're actually five times more likely to stay quit forever. So why not take the opportunity to get free, personalised support in order to quit forever? There's no better time to protect you and your children from the dangers of smoking. So search Stoptober online and sign up today.